is. Masa says, "Hey, it's the princess." Mune says, "Whoa, I think you're right." Masa says, "I wonder what happened. Do you think we should help her?" Mune says, "Nah, it's not our job." Masa says, "Yeah, I guess so. It's probably out of our league anyway." Yep. Doreen says, "Hey, we aren't heartless." Mune says, "The princess is bound by the past, and even we can't bring her back here." Doreen says, "Look closely, see that?" Masa says, "Hey, the time egg?" Doreen says, "Yes, although it's not in its complete form." Masa says, "Did that girl with the glasses make it?" Doreen says, "Probably. Even though it's in its incomplete form, we can focus our powers." Mune says, "Maybe it'll work." Masa says, "Hey, new master." Masa says, "Yep, that's you." Doreen says, "We're gonna lend you our power for a little bit. We're sending you back to the past where the princess is. We only have one chance. Make sure you take care of her."
Thank you.
Kid says, "Bunny, have you been? I'm right here." Radius says, "Thank goodness, this must be the power of Bunny's love." "Ah yes, Kid. Lucia is waiting for you at Viper Manor. She wanted to give you something. Anyway, there's no rush. I suggest you rest for the rest of the day." Kid says, "My wound? Link stabbed me. What are you talking about?" "Wait a minute, not again. I lose my memory sometimes. Whenever I'm in a dangerous situation where I might get hurt, I seem to disappear and vanish. And when I come to, I wake up somewhere safe without a scratch. But the thing is, I can't remember what happened. I don't get it. Anyway, it's happened to me plenty of times in the past. It's nothing to worry about. Come on, mate, let's go." Oops, I think I forgot to do something. Thank you. Starkey says, "Wow, my ship in this world isn't broken. I'm really happy." Kid says, "Could that be the reason why we have air down here?" Starkey says, "Affirmative. Starkey's ship creates a force field." Starkey think in the other world, my ship is in pieces and the parts are buried underground. Starkey says, "Yeah, it opened." Everything's in order. The navigational system is operational. Starkey's bed is nice and cozy, too. Kid says, "Can this take us to Terra Tower?" Starkey says, "It's only big enough to fly me." Kid says, "Then what do we do?" Starkey says, "Leave it there." The engine may be a bit rusty, but otherwise it's perfect. Maybe we can use this. Starkey may be able to scrounge up some more stuff. Easy does it. Kid says, "What's this?" Starkey says, "An anti-gravity device. If you attach this to your boat, it will fly to Terra Tower easy. All we need now is a facility to install it." Kid says, "I remember there was a dock inside of Chronopolis." Starkey says, "All right, let's go there." Starkey says, "Let's see, I need this and that. Oh yeah, this should do the trick." Kid says, "All you have to do is load that thing on the boat, right?" Starkey says, "What are you talking about? We need to attach a stabilizer to keep the auto gyro from spinning out of control." Kid says, "I don't get it, but just hurry it up, okay?" Starkey says, "Time to work." Ooh, Starkey's done. Kid says, "See, all you did was load it on the boat." Starkey says, "Negative." Kid says, "So this is it. Never expected our encounter to turn out like this, did you, Bunny?" Starkey says, "Why were we born? Why do we live?" Kid says, "That's what we're gonna find out." Alrighty. Kid says, "Let's do it." Switch my party. Have dried up and withered. Is it your to choose.
Thank you.
kid says, "What is that? Are you human?" "When I was still human, I was locked up here, and I've been here ever since. This tower is a fortress belonging to the ancient Riptides, a symbol of revenge brought against mankind by the dragons. With the defeat of fate, the seal has been broken, and this tower has surfaced. In the eyes of the dragons, we humans are the foes. A brain that has developed abnormally to 3 times the original size in the span of 3 million years. We humans have evolved at an enormous rate because of our contact with Lavos. In a sense, mankind is Lavos' offspring. We humans are extraneous to this planet. How will you fight, bunny?" Could this be Viper Manor? What's going on? The prophet says, welcome. It's good to see you finally made it here. I've been expecting you, bunny. Kid says, where are we? Is this Viper Manor? The prophet says, this is a space that does not exist. But don't mind that. More importantly, I have something I must explain to you. Kid says, who are you? Prophet says, my name is Balthazar. In the ancient magical kingdom of Zeal, I was known as a sage of reason. That was up until the queen of Zeal attempted to harness the power of Lavos. Let's just say things got out of control and Lavos created a dimensional vortex that threw me far into the future. There I seized the opportunity to study the science of the future. I was then able to apply that knowledge I brought from my own era, including magic, which was long lost. Anyway, this led me to make huge progress in the research of time. That research led to the creation of Chronopolis and to the time crash. You might think I really blew it, but perhaps it was my finest hour. Anyway, I created a compact time machine that I dubbed the Neo Epoch. I used it to time warp to this age to learn of Chronopolis and Fate's plans, and to see how things were turning. Terra Tower is really a city of the Reptites from another dimension's future. It was originally Dinopolis, the castle of Azala's descendants who achieved an evolution much more intimate with our planet. Dinopolis was drawn into this dimension's past about 10,000 years ago. This was done so that it would serve as a counterbalance against Chronopolis, which Lavos pulled here. Needless to say, a battle ensued. In the end, Chronopolis emerged as the victor, and the Reptite's fortress was sealed away by fate. But more important, now is the role the dragons play in all this. Originally, the whole archipelago of El Nido was known as the Sea of Eden. This was because it was where the dragon gods resided. But then fate sealed away the dragon god's powers, in effect becoming a god itself. Thus, the islands where the new godhead fate existed came to be called the Sea of Eden instead. Perhaps you didn't realize it, but you were used by the dragon gods to eliminate fate. It was not true that the dragon gods sealed away the frozen flame. Rather, it's quite the opposite. It was fate that used the power of the flame to seal up the dragons. In reality, the dragons are in opposition to man, while fate itself was actually the protector of humanity. The dragon gods were originally a singular plasma life form, a living accumulation of the planet's energy. Originally, it was a biological machine used to control the powers of nature in the future society of the Reptites. In order to control the natural energy itself, fate divided one dragon god entity up into six weaker plasma life forms, then scattered them across the sea and sealed them away. Their dragon-like appearances are just pseudo-guises. Temporary forms they take so that they can appear in this dimension. But all that changed when fate was vanquished, and its power hold is eliminated. At that moment, the seven dragons who had been rendered almost powerless and forgotten traveled across the dimensions to reunite into a single entity. Kid says seven, I thought there was only six. Balthazar says there were six you knew of and one more hidden you didn't, like the second moon that once was lost but later found. Although the same planet in my world didn't have two moons. Look up at the night sky now and you will see seven celestial bodies, five stars, two moons, five brother stars that correspond to the five colored dragons ruling like gods over the night skies, one moon that corresponds to the white sky dragon, and another darker daughter moon to counterbalance them. Fire, water, green, earth, black, sky, and one more. The final dragon, the Dark Moon Dragon. The one who was to work to free the other dragoons from their bondage by the computer. The child the others created on the night of the electric storm that temporarily caused fate to loosen its hold on them. I believe you knew her as Harley. Kid says, unbelievable. Balthazar says the dragon gods were the essence of nature on this planet. Perhaps we can consider what's happening as our planet's vengeance on us. to finally sweep away the unwanted humans from the face of this blue planet. Kid says, first it was fate, now it's the planet. Balthazar says, or vice versa, but either way you look at it, now's the time to set things right. The future of mankind, the destiny of this planet, everything depends on the next battle you will fight. But unfortunately, the time has come for us to part. Hey, mister, is that the Chrono Cross you guys have there? The melody and harmony. It has the power to cross space and time and unify people's thoughts and feelings. It has the power to transfer memories. By using it as an element, it has the power to draw on the sounds of the six colored elements to produce a healing harmony. It has the power to combine the sounds of the world into one melody. Balthazar says, I'm sure we'll meet again soon, in one time period or another. Be careful now, and good luck. Disconnecting and reconnecting. Kid says, buddy, up there. That must be the summit. Glenn says, look, there's two beams coming from either side. I wonder if they act as some kind of sealing device. Disconnecting for no reason.
Thank you.
Disrespecting the origins of life, Mother Sea suffers. Help, stop it, kill me. Welcome, humans. Those who know the torment and joy of creation. Oh, let me go back, because I didn't realize there's going to be that. Arg, help, stop it, kill me. Welcome. Welcome, humans. Those who know the torment and joy of creation know also the pleasure and pain of destruction. Therefore, all that pass through here must be prepared to share the burden that I carry. Kid says, so this is the true frozen flame, Struth. Kid says, hold on, let's touch it. Is everyone okay? Bugger you, us humans ain't gonna let you have your way any longer. Show yourself. In order to survive, all living things in this world fight desperately and devour those they defeat. Must one kill other living things in order to survive? Must one destroy another world in order to allow one's own world to continue? The wounded, in turn, wound those bigger than they themselves are. There are only the killers and the killed, the sinners and the judge, the victims. What meaning is there in such a world? The kid says, whether there's meaning or not, we still go on living. We've got no right to deny that. The enemy says, I shall cleanse this blue planet of you filthy humans once and for all. We'll be right back. Balthazar said, that thing, the dragon god, is only a quasi-existence, a temporary form that the real dragon god uses in order to appear within this dimension. The actual dragon god was consumed long ago in the distant past, integrated by the entity known as Labos in a time on the other side of the dimensional darkness. The frozen flame is a splinter from the extraterrestrial being Labos. The one who connects with the frozen flame in effect links with Labos. As the mediator between Labos and living things, that one will gain extraordinary powers. By binding with the new seed of destruction, the devourer of time. Kid says, what blazes? Mystery voice says, go to the place where time became divided and weave the threads together. Balthazar says, the devourer of time is a new life form, born out of the fusion of a life form from this planet with Labos, who nests on the far side of the dimensional void. In the far-off future, when the fusion becomes complete, it will awaken. Then, the devourer of time will begin to consume all space-time continua. Despair and hatred to return all things to nothingness, that is what it desires. Balthazar says, here, take this with you. That time egg will allow you to travel between space-time. The world is in your hands. Go, release the life that is imprisoned. Kid says, that's Terra Tower's final form. In the end, we're all the same. Everyone dreams of being greater and more powerful. Glenn says, we've come this far. All that remains is to defeat the Devourer of Time. Once we wipe the Devourer of Time off the face of this planet, it's all over. Hopefully, everything will go back to normal. Kid says, you're wrong. Things won't ever go back to the way they were. Fate is dead. From now on, humans have to choose our own way. We also have to take responsibility for the choices we make. And something's gotta be done about the way we go on hurting and killing one another. We've gotta settle our differences once and for all. Listen, what's really important is what we do now. The issue isn't whether we defeat that bastard or not. I'm afraid that, depending on how we go about it, we could lose out on gaining something really precious. So the issue is the way we fight. Glenn says, so where on earth is the real devourer of time? Kid says, my guess is the key to finding it lies at the beach. That's where this whole thing started. It's probably where it'll end.
Thank you.
You can just normally kill it, but you might as well do it the right way. Get the best ending. Still very impressed by this graphics. Like, I've never had an up-render look this magnificent before. That we call planets, and the immature spermatozoa, which gather around these that we call life forms, when one of those countless seeds inseminates a planet, a new universe is born. But until that occurs, hundreds of millions of years will pass, and innumerable life forms will be born and then die. That is the be-all, end-all, everything exists for that one moment, all so that the universe can evolve into the next dimension. Does that make us all just pawns? Are each of our short lives nothing but a cheap sacrifice, just so the one chosen life form can be born? No, that's not the case. Each and every one of us has a chance of becoming that one chosen life form, which inseminates a planet. Yes, if you do. Good knowing you, mate. Thanks for being born. I guess now's the time to say see you later, but I'll find you sometime, somewhere. I'm sure of it. matter what time period, no matter what world you live in, I'll find you. I'm sure. Bunny. Hey. Bunny. Lena says, are you all right? What's the matter? Hold on. That's going to be impossible to talk over. Lena says, don't scare me like that. You just passed out all of a sudden. Terra Tower? Fate? What are you talking about? You got some Komodo dragon scales for me, don't you remember? You sound confused. Come on, get with the program. Our summer just started. Thus the curtain closes on another tale. An eternity has passed. Fleeting dreams fade into the distance. All that is left now is me and my memories. And some cocaine. Hell yeah. But I'm sure we'll meet again. Someday, you and I. Another place, another time. It's just that we might not realize that you are you and I am me.
Thank you.
I will find you, even if I have to search the world over. Somewhere, sometime, I'm sure. It hath been finished. Let me reconnect my controller really fast. Anyways, thank you for joining me. The game is now over. I will be back someday with a different game.